This week on Maker Update, a fog machine for your pocket, a CNC for under $500, flip dots, fidgets, contests, maker books, and maker fairs. It's Wednesday, October 26th. I'm Donald Bell, and welcome to another episode of Maker Update. I've had a great week. There's a lot of new subscribers to the channel, so thank you everyone for helping to get the word out. It really helped. And had a great time at Maker Fair, East Bay Maker Fair in Oakland on Sunday. I got to run into a lot of my old friends at Make Magazine. I got to see so much cool stuff. And I got to meet Anouk Whipwrecht and talk to her about her new dress she's working on. I'm not going to tell you about it yet, but let's just say it involves Furbies. But there's still a lot to cover in this episode, so we're going to jump right into it, starting with the project of the week. This week, one of my favorite new makers and an artist in residence at Autodesk Pier 9, Scott McIndoe, posted an instructable for a portable battery-powered fog machine. Scott here hacked together an ingenious combination of an E-Cig vaporizer, a PC fan, and a 3D printed enclosure. The vaporizer runs the same non-toxic fog fluid as a conventional fog machine, and the whole thing can be put together for under $100. Now, if you don't have a 3D printer, there's a link right in the instructable for working with a local 3D Hubs member to have it printed and shipped. Pricing was around $20 to $30 when I looked. All right, two things I love about this project. Number one, it gives me a totally legitimate excuse to buy a vaporizer. Number two, and more importantly, Scott made this fun, useful thing that didn't exist before, and he gave it away to all of us. And I know that sounds simple, but in the Venn diagram of fun, useful, unprecedented, and free, those things rarely overlap. So thank you, Scott. And now for news. This past Tuesday, maker Barr Smith launched a Kickstarter campaign for a scalable CNC router that costs under $500. It's called Maslow, and unlike most CNC routers that use a table design, the Maslow is tilted up vertically, and it sort of reminds me of those panel saws that you see in Home Depot that can break down big sheets of plywood. There's a lot of interesting design choices here, from the geared DC motors, the chains, the use of bricks as counterbalance, but it all seems to check out, and for under $500, it's really hard to ignore. It may not be as precise as a ShopBot, but it's a fraction of the price, it takes up less space, gravity takes care of clearing away the dust, and if it breaks at $500, I'm not even that angry. And what makes this even more newsworthy for us is the fact that it's been completely open sourced. If you wanna make this thing right now, you totally can. I've got a link in the show notes for the parts and the software. All right, and now for more projects. This week, I indulged my obsession with flipdot displays. These are those electromechanical displays that are used in fancy train stations where a magnet will physically flip a plastic pixel one way or the other. I love the way they look, and even more, I love the way they sound like a sizzling, glitchy maraca. So to my delight, last week I saw a company, Breakfast NY, that is selling these as a fully assembled flip dot display. They have an amazing video that demos the whole thing, and for me, I could just listen to this with my eyes closed and enjoy it just as much. And as cool as that is, it's not a project. It's like a prefab thing that's really meant for startups to buy and show off in their lobby. But it got me thinking about flip dot displays again, and that led me to this. This project, called Vote With Your Feet by Cheng XX, was part of the Market Street Prototyping Festival in San Francisco, which is worth checking out in its own right, and I'll leave a link in the notes. The project gives pedestrians a chance to vote on a question posed by a flip dot sign, and then their vote is registered as they walk through the door of their choice. Now, it's a cool project, but it's a little bit too complicated to fall into my ideal project category of something that's cool yet realistically achievable. It uses an Omax industrial water jet, for God's sake, but within this project, there is the holy grail of what I've been looking for, which is an August 2016 instructable on how to easily animate flip dot displays using a Raspberry Pi. I know that took a ridiculously long time to get to the actual project, but here it is. How to Flip Dot with a Raspi by Philetus is the best resource I've seen yet on how to easily get these displays up and running and animated with just two connections. He includes details on where to buy the displays, the SparkFun USB converter you'll need to interface with it, dip switch settings, Pi settings, and the Python script that will get a custom message scrolling. Maybe I'm crazy and I'm the only one who thinks that these displays are magic, but just in case you feel the same way, now you know where to go. For those of you with 3D printers, another interesting thing I found this week is a collection on Thingiverse dedicated to fidget spinners. These are generally some kind of handheld toy meant for mindless fidgeting, but what I've noticed is a recent boom in designs that integrate ball bearings for spinning. There's at least 20 designs here just from October. This feels like a trend to me. Like, I think they look like fun. I haven't made one myself. Maybe one of you can explain to me, leave a comment for me, and let me know what the sudden surge in interest is all about. When did we get so obsessed with fidgeting? Books! I'm gonna do something new here, and I'm gonna run through a list of recently released maker books that I think you guys should know about. The first is Workshop Mastery with Jimmy DiResta. This came out yesterday. Is $20, and if for some crazy reason you haven't heard of Jimmy DiResta, please leave this video now and look him up on YouTube. The book is full of workshop skills and projects, and there's a foreword by Nick Offerman, who coincidentally also has a book that just came out on the 18th called Good Clean Fun, full of woodworking projects. I've got links to all of these books in the show notes. I also want to let you know about two new books from Dale Doherty, the creator of Maker Faire and Make Magazine. The first is called Maker City, A Practical Guide for Reinventing Our Cities. It's co-written with Peter Hirschberg and Marsha Kadnoff. It's $20, and if you're interested in some truly earned insight on how makers and local government can symbiotically benefit from each other, this is your book. Dale also has a book out called Free to Make, which is essentially a $12 introduction to the maker movement and all its facets, its historical roots, and where it's going, and why it matters. This is probably the book I should buy from my mom to help explain why I'm out here in a shed filming a video for no money. It's the maker movement! Again, I've got Amazon links for all these books in the show notes. You should check them all out. We have some maker contests ending soon on Instructables, just in case you want to whip something together and see what happens. All four Halloween contests end on November 7th, including props, costumes, food, and decor. A pumpkin carving contest also got tacked on, ending November 14th. And you also have yarn and survival ending on the 14th, and maybe you could just find a way to survive in a knit tent, eating carved pumpkins and Halloween food, and then you just sweep all the categories. It's a slow weekend for maker fairs. This weekend, there's just three, one happening in Lyon, Spain, Wenatchee, Washington, and New Taipei City in Taiwan. And that's it for this episode of Maker Update. In case you haven't noticed, I am publishing these every Wednesday morning. I've never actually said that out loud until now, so I thought I'd let you know. If you're subscribed on YouTube, you'll see a new episode every Wednesday morning. I also haven't mentioned this for a while. You can email me. I'm donald@makerprojectlab.com. If you've got a great project or a bit of maker news or a cool tip or a cool event, let me know about it. I love hearing from you guys. You can also just leave a comment on this video. That works too. And if you like this video, please hit the share button. That's the best thing you can do for me. You can think of that share button as my tip jar. All right? I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching.